Lastly, this was a pretty polarizing interview on The Jump. Anthony Davis has voiced, I wouldn't say displeasure. I've never heard like 1 ounce of criticism come from Anthony Davis, but this was, it's sort of like when you never get anything and right. then you get a little peek into the window of their home. It's like, oh, right. I think I know something here. So here's what Anthony Davis said on The Jump to Rachel Nichols about.
Rachel Nichols is so good though. She asked the right question. Mm-hmm. That was perfect. It was a perfect how she did
it. Yes, it was perfect. And I mean, she's perfect.
Yeah.
So here's what occurred. Rachel Nichols' interview with Anthony Davis. Take a look.
But at some point, will he ask for a trade? Davis acknowledges he's heard ex-players like Kevin Garnett say they regret not asking to move to a more competitive franchise earlier in their careers.
Yeah, when you hear that, it makes you think. I'm not gonna lie, it makes you think. So you wonder if you're following in that same path. But then again, you're like, this year could be the year. Like, you don't know, you know? So, you just gotta take it year by year and just see, you know, see where the team is going, what direction they want to go to, and just see where they're headed.
Is it good enough for you to make the playoffs? Does that feel enough?
It's not. I've done that before, and nobody talks about it. Nobody talks about just making a playoff, you know? So, and I feel like we can do more. We have to. You know, they always say basketball is a game of runs. This might be our run. You know, you don't know.
And this also came, I should have said, this came after Anthony Davis's teammate and also Kentucky stalwart, Boogie Cousins, had a torn Achilles, very disappointed. He gets it. He's 24 years old, yet it seems like he's wise beyond his years because he never says anything controversial.
Yep.
And he just gets that. He understands that it's more than just making the playoffs. He wants to be loyal to New Orleans.
Right.
But in a way, he wants New Orleans to be loyal to him by bringing in better talent. Tough to do with the market that they have because there's already the New Yorks, the LAs, the Chicagos, and what have you.
Right.
So they're already down middle market for the NBA. But he just doesn't want to be content with making the playoffs, which I truly understand and appreciate.
No, I agree 100%. I mean, it's difficult because you want to, it's such a fine line that he's crossing, right? Where you want to remain loyal to this team. And, you know, he's the staple of the team, really. Like the Pelicans rely so much on him. And then when Boogie came on board, it was like the dynamic duo. A lot of people expected it, you know, a lot to come from that. And then that injury came. And now he's forced to carry, you know, he has to put up at least, what, like 40 points just to carry the team. It's absolutely ridiculous. A lot of pressure. And then, you know, then you know he's focusing. He's seeing everybody else do great, and he's putting in the number. He's going to practice every day, and he's watching his peers just take off who are in other teams. And then you can't help but think, like, man, am I falling under this like KG kind of story? Like, you know, should I turn the page? Like, he was with the Timberwolves, and he turned the page like 12 seasons into the Timberwolves. Like, he still has time to save himself from wasting. I don't want to say wasting. I guess, yeah, for lack of a better term, wasting time with the Pelicans and move on to get that much closer to a ring or rings.
Right. And the big thing with KG that I think everyone has to remember is that he was gifted an essential transfer by Kevin McHale, who was running the Minnesota Timberwolves. And I will die on that cliff, always sputing that, because they got nothing in return. They got Al Jefferson, who was, if he was born 30 years earlier, could have been one of the most dominant big men.
Right.
The NBA was not built for Al Jefferson
when
he was traded, when he was drafted and then traded by the Boston Celtics to the Timberwolves. And now, of course, he's with the Pacers on a long journey in the NBA. There's a few things that have happened. Firstly, the contracts. So if you're wondering, when can Anthony Davis possibly just go to another team? Well, he can't for a while. So he's highlighted at the top via Basketball Reference. Yeah, this season. Look, he's getting paid. It's not about the money at this point. Especially with a lot of the new blood in the NBA, it's not going to be about the money. What it's going to be about is winning and his rings. So he's under contract until 2020, 2021, and I believe that is a player option. So he can either stay after this season for another 2 years when he's roughly 26, 27, or he can opt out and then test free agency. I do not believe that the Pelicans would allow him to leave for nothing. They would probably trade him either in 2018, 2019 or 2019, 2020. The return would have to believe be insurmountable in order for this to happen.
Right.
But there are a few things that have occurred that I have realized. And the first is, the Boogie Cousins injury tearing his Achilles terrible. Drew Holiday has never really been healthy for a full 82 game season, or he's had to sit out because of the devastating brain tumor that his wife Lauren Holiday had prior to the season. The third is that Monty Williams was fired as head coach. Alvin Gentry comes in and he goes, no, we got to play fast and we got to be like the Golden State Warriors, because I was there as an assistant coach. There's only one Golden State Warriors, so thus we saw the downslope that this team was on once again. The more important thing is, would we be mad at all as NBA fans if Anthony Davis just kept saying that he wants more?
New Orleans probably would be. That's the only, I feel like that's the only kind of NBA fan that would be mad at that. Because realistically speaking, like DeMarcus Cousins isn't even going to be healthy or as close to healthy until
a year.
No, honestly, like, because I'd say like even like a year and a half, 2 years just to fully recover. And even then, like, we don't know what we're going to be getting back. Is it going to be the same DeMarcus Cousins? Like, not that I feel like he's ever like really, really like hit. He was like so close to hitting that prime. And then unfortunately, he had to have this devastating injury. But we don't know what he's going to come back to. Is it going to be the same DeMarcus Cousins that got, you know, into the, when he got into the Pelicans? We don't know. So there's so much pressure that comes into Anthony Davis, and there's so much wear and tear that he's going to be going to just carrying this team on his shoulders the way that he has been. The playing time that he gets is absolutely ridiculous, and I don't know. I feel like if after his contract ends, I feel like it would make the most sense for him to make that move.
Where do you think he would go? Where's like a good place to
Chicago.
Go? Chicago. I would love
then
that.
Then you would really flex that. Where does he have that? Right here, right? He has like the Chicago tattoo.
I mean,
go to the Bulls, make some history there, your hometown, you know, get the key to the city, do what you got to do. Mm-hmm. But I feel like Chicago for me would be the place that would make the most sense. Would he get a ring? I don't know. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying that he would make such a huge impact in the city.
Yeah, probably.